Kashmir limping back to normalcy, phone lines to be restored, schools to reopen, governor orders normal functioning of offices. Nation remembers former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee in his first death anniversary. Manipur also observes today. Numaligarh refinery records highest ever revenue from operations, contributes 4,000 crore rupees to exchequers. NF Railway General Manager discusses safety measures to prevent mishaps with divisional managers through video conferencing. And Ravi Shastri reappointed head coach of Team India. Good evening, viewers, and welcome to the Northeast News Bulletin. This is Satwati Bhuya. Now with the details. Situation of Jammu and Kashmir is limping back to normalcy. Jammu and Kashmir Chief Secretary BVR Subramaniam said most phone lines would be restored by the weekend and schools would reopen next week. Offices of the Jammu and Kashmir government in the valley functioned normally today and the attendance in many offices was quite high, Subramaniam said at a press conference. He said there had been no loss of life or major incidents since restrictions were imposed on August 5 when Jammu and Kashmir's special status under Article 370 was revoked and the state bifurcated into two union territories. There would be easing of restrictions in the next few days in an orderly way, Subramaniam told reporters in Srinagar, adding that steps would be taken keeping in view the evolving situation as well as the cooperation of the people in maintaining calm and peace.
Or serious injuries to anyone during the course of maintaining peace and order. We have prevented any loss of human life despite concerted efforts by terrorist organizations, radical groups.
Meanwhile, Governor Satyapal Malik has directed that normal functioning of the Civil Secretariat Srinagar and government offices should be resumed immediately. He directed that arrangements should be made to facilitate movement of government employees to work. After the Friday prayers, based on the developments during the day, relaxations could be considered subsequently. These directions were given by the Governor after reviewing the conduct of Independence Day celebrations and the security scenario with the advisors and Chief Secretary at the Raj Bhavan, Srinagar on Thursday evening. The governor was informed that Independence Day celebrations were conducted across Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh with joy, fervor and enthusiasm. There were no untoward incidents anywhere. Today is first death anniversary of former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. The BJP stalwart had breathed his last on this day last year. Atal Bihari Vajpayee served as the Prime Minister for three times. His first term was only for 13 days in 1996. He served his second term for a period of 11 months from 1998 to 1999 and then a full term from 1999 to 2004. He was awarded India's highest civilian honour, Bharat Ratna, in 2015. Many functions were held across the country in memory of the great leader. President Ramnath Kovind today paid floral tributes at the tombstone to late former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee at Sadaiv Atal Memorial. Prime Minister Narendra Modi also paid homage to the former Prime Minister in a prayer meeting in New Delhi. Union Minister Amit Shah, Dr. Harshvardhan, Dharmendra Pradhan and other leaders also paid homage. On the other hand, in Manipur, Chief Minister N. Biren today said former Prime Minister and Bharat Ratna recipient Atal Bihari Vajpayee had predicted 20 years back that BJP would rule India and it had now come true. Delivering his speech as chief guest at a function to observe the first death anniversary of Atal Bihari Vajpayee in Imphal, the said Prime Minister Narendra Modi's policies Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Vishwas received its inspiration from the philosophy and ideology of late Atal Bihari Vajpayee. In news from Nagaland, Governor R.N. Ravi today said the dark shadow of the unresolved Naga political issue cast its shadow on every aspect of Naga life. Speaking at a civic reception in his honor at NBCC Convention Center, Kohima, he said this cloud must go because the Naga people deserved sunshine. Chief Minister Nefirio in his speech described the new governor as no stranger to the Naga people because of his role as the center's interlocutor for the Naga political issue and whose name was known to every household in Nagaland. Ravi was a man who had extensively studied the history and political affairs of the Naga society and whose immense contributions led to the signing of the framework agreement, he added. In Assam, the 26th annual general meeting of Numaligarh Refinery Limited was held at NRL Corporate Office, Guwahati today. In his address, NRL Chairman NRLD Rajkumar said that during the year 2018-19, the company had recorded the highest ever revenue of 18,511 crore rupees from operations, registering a growth of more than 16% over the previous year, though the profit after tax was marginally lower at 1,968 crore rupees as compared to last year. NRL's contribution to the central and state exchequers in the form of taxes, duties and dividends during the year was 4,159 crore rupees. Rajkumar said NRL was the rising star of the Northeast and he saw a great future for it as one of the front-ranking global energy companies.
1,511 crore 51 crores, signifying strong economic fundamentals of the company. Rightfully so, so far it is indeed a harbinger.
In Assam, the NF Railway General Manager today had a video conference on railway safety and measures to prevent accidents from the NFR headquarters, Maligaon, Guwahati. All high officials of the headquarters were present. All divisional railway managers of NFR were connected by the video conferencing. A railway safety book was also released during the program.
At times it may not be convenient, that time or time may not be available to really look for the booklet and what other.
In Assam, the branch managers under Guwahati Division of the Central Bank India will meet from tomorrow in a two-day program in Guwahati. Informing this at a press meet in the city, Senior Regional Manager of the bank Satish Agarwal said the meet would discuss issues like digital transaction and loans for small industries.
आप सब जानते हैं कि ग्रोथ रेट जब इकोनॉमी की डाउन आती है वो इसका इफेक्ट सभी पर पड़ता है.
Nagaland State Police Department got its first laboratory-cum-training center for prevention of cybercrime against women and children on Thursday. Inaugurating the center at Police Training School Chumukdema in Dimapur District, Deputy Chief Minister Y. Patton said, cybercrimes posed a great challenge to the traditional policing and as such, the police personnel needed to sharpen their skills to tackle the threats. He said awareness creation for prevention of cybercrimes must be given priority while imparting trainings as most people fell victims to cyber crimes due to ignorance. Stating that women and children were among the vulnerable section of the society, the Deputy Chief Minister said that through this center, police personnel would be trained in specific topics related to cyber crimes. In Assam, Shok Divas was observed at Janata Bhavan, Guwahati today along with the rest of the state to mourn the tragic deaths of innocent children and other persons in a bomb blast while attending the Independence Day celebration at Dhemaji in the year 2008. Additional Chief Secretary Rajiv Kumar Bora administered a pledge against all acts of terrorism and militant violence. 1 minute of silence was observed in memory of the children and the other persons who had lost their lives in the extremist violence. In Assam, the Cachar District Administration, in association with the Cachar Sporting Club, today organized a swimming competition and a boat race in the Barak River in Madhurbon, Silchar. Among the distinguished spectators who enjoyed watching the race from a ship were Forest Minister Porimal Shuklabaidya and Deputy Speaker of the State Legislative Assembly Aminul Haq Laskar. The event was held to celebrate the country's 73rd Independence Day. Later winners at the event, Nasir Ahmed, Krishmoni and Noor Saha, received awards from Minister Shuklabaidya and Deputy Commissioner L. Madhuri. Incumbent Ravi Shastri was today reappointed head coach of the Indian men's team by the Kapil Dev-led Cricket Advisory Committee, a decision that was expected and has the backing of Captain Virat Kohli. Shastri has been reappointed for a two-year period ending with the 2021 T20 World Cup in India. This will be Shastri's fourth stint with the national team, having served briefly as the cricket manager in 2007 tour of Bangladesh, team director from 2014 to 2016, and head coach from 2017 to 2019. Shastri pipped former India teammates Robin Singh and Lalchand Rajput along with former New Zealand coach Mike Hexton and Australian Tom Moody to the post. Former West Indies and Afghanistan coach Phil Simmons pulled out of the race, citing personal reasons. In a unique performance, a boy in Manipur has set a new Guinness World Record for most push-ups with one hand and one leg in 1 minute. Thaunazam Niranjoy Singh of Naran Konjin Namang Lekai has created a new world record by achieving the most push-ups on one arm and one leg in just one. Niranjoy attempted to break the previous record at a gym at Konong Mamang, Imphal East. He completed 37 push-ups using one arm and one leg, breaking the previous record. Researchers have discovered a new sensory organ in the skin that is able to detect painful mechanical damage such as pricks and impacts, an advance that may help develop novel painkillers. Almost one person in every five experiences constant pain, and there is a considerable need to find new pain-killing drugs, according to research published in the journal Science. However, sensitivity to pain is also required for survival, and it has a protective function. It prompts reflex reactions that prevent damage to tissue, such as pulling your hand away when you feel a jab from a sharp object or when you burn yourself. Researchers at Karolinska Institute in Sweden have now discovered a new sensory organ in the skin that is sensitive to hazardous environmental irritation. And finally, in Manipur, security forces on Thursday detected an improvised explosive device IED while patrolling at Nongampat area in Imphal East district, officials said. Experts of the bomb squad cordoned off the area and detonated the IED at a safe place. The IED, which weighed around 1 kg, was discovered around 10:30 a.m. Now, the weather report.
Satellite imagery over the northeast shows that rain and thundershower is likely to occur over Assam and Meghalaya and at isolated places of the region during the next 24 hours. The temperatures recorded today at some of the state capitals of the region are as follows. Guwahati recorded a maximum.
Before we wind up the bulletin, a recap of the headlines. Kashmir limping back to normalcy, phone lines to be restored, schools to reopen, governor orders normal functioning of offices. Nation remembers former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee in his first death anniversary. Manipur also observes today. Numaligarh refinery records highest ever revenue from operations, contributes 4,000 crore rupees to exchequers. NF Railway General Manager discusses safety measures to prevent mishaps with divisional managers through video conferencing. And Ravi Shastri reappointed head coach of Team India. That brings us to the end of this evening's bulletin. Thank you for tuning in. Namaskar.